Robbie is a one of a kind guy.
I consider Robbie a warrior as a performer.
I love him. I've wanted this for him for so long.
He's just a genius.
And he's just a love. I just love working with him.
We just wouldn't be where we are now in Phoenix Theater and in the theater community if we didn't have him.
I just think Robbie's amazing. Robbie is a delight to work with because of his spirit, his energy. There's always something, there's always lots of things that are going on. But when Robbie's with you, he's present and he's excited and he's enthusiastic.
Robbie is both passionate and kind. And I think that combination really drives you to be better than you are.
He brings himself to his projects. And what I mean by that is he never shies away from pushing himself to something new, trying something new and different. He never shies away from adding weight to what he does.
Robbie is a delight to work with because his energy and passion and joy just permeate the rehearsal room.
Robbie is a delight to work with because of his enthusiasm, his energy, his kindness, his sweetness.
He knows what he likes and he knows what he doesn't like, and I actually really appreciate that.
He listens and he responds to what you actually ask him. He finds a way to do it so that you learn and also enjoy hearing his response.
He is just a delight. Like, he can be in a terrible mood and he's just fun and makes the situation fun. Just the vibe that when you walk into the meeting, you know, everything was like, everything's cool. You know, I just love that.
Who?
He is upbeat, he is smart, he is funny, he shares. He's a font of useful information. He lets you play.
I remember that guy. What a dick.
What makes him so delightful is the ease in which he works. The ease that he brings to everyone in the room working with him. And when challenges arise, he adapts. He adapts well, and he adapts with grace.
Robbie is a delight to work with because he is hilarious. He makes it fun, and he makes it fun to be there, and he makes you want to be there and working with him.
I have never met anybody who is so collaborative and yet so in charge. He embodies both. He can take you down the path, and it's sometimes a painful, scary path, and you feel no pain because he just knows how to pull the weeds out of the way and get those sticky bushes out of the way, and he makes it a joyful experience.
It just makes the process fun and interesting, and I learn. Every time I work with him, whether as an actor or choreographer, I learn, and that's just awesome.
He's generous of spirit, he's honest, he's giving, he's loving, he's a creative genius.
What makes Robbie a delight to work with, I think, is his sense of humor. He's hilarious and always, you're always giggling with him.
Did I mention he's fucking talented? Jeez, he always makes me want to be better.
He is authentically himself all the time. And that authentic self that he is beautiful and creative and filled with light and energy and electricity that he's just ready to connect.
I mean, like, for me, it's his level of sarcasm, I think.
Robbie is a delight to work with because he is so fun and genuine and honest. He makes anybody feel like they're really good at things that they may not be really good at, i.e. train time steps.
I believe he has this just magical power that he's a people whisperer. And I truly, he just connects to one's each one's heart in that sense. And that's what makes him such a delight to work with. Don't forget to
remember me. He had a little moment in Mary Poppins that I'm going to get. I loved this moment. I get teary-eyed thinking about it. It's a little moment when at the very end, he's just a man going to the bank for a loan, and Mr. Banks has now changed his moment, and he goes in with his hat in hand and he talks to Mr. Banks. And this little moment, which most people probably don't even know is in the show, every time I saw it, I thought, oh my God, this is why Robbie's so good, because he made that moment just spring to life for me.
I didn't like the show that much, but I loved him in Whore House.
Gosh, I can't recall the production, because I think there's several that this has happened, that he's running off stage, sweat pouring off his face, trying to get out of whatever garb it is, and yet just pops back on in a new character. He does it with humor, but professionalism.
I was going to trade him my brother, who I'd known all my life, my head, for this girl. And all that had to be said was I had to make a decision on stage, and then I had to say the word deal. And Robbie allowed me to explore that moment for as long as I could, depending on the audience, of course.
Hey, Virgin, you got time to lean, you got time to clean.
I just always look forward to getting a hug from Robbie. I'm sure I'm not the only one. He just gives the best hugs.
I'll never forget this. He took me outside and had a heart-to-heart and told me it was okay. That one-on-one moment in the lobby at the Phoenix Theater Company was, I don't want to be dramatic and say life-changing, but life-changing. It truly touched me.
It was the eye contact he gave me during scenes when he could see that I was sweating through a three-piece suit visibly and drowning in my own moistness. And I could see the eyes he was giving me during the scene that read subtextually as, I see you, boo. I know you're wet. I'm sorry there's nothing I can do to help you, but I'll help you get through this scene.
And Bent, I had the pleasure of murdering him. It's pretty awful, but it was this really intense scene and a very memorable scene, and he was brilliant in it. And he stood there as I whipped him to death with a baton of some sort. I love that this beautiful, sweet, loving, funny, warm, sensitive guy is this amazing dramatic actor too, and he dies like a pro.
And he had one line where he had to say about Mammy's cooking. And he was going, kind of very high like that. And David Tsar would have asked him, can you maybe pitch that a little lower? And so then Robbie did, and it was like this. So it's like a couple tones lower, but still had a high pitch. It was so hilarious. I loved it.
When he was given a cane for One Man, Two Governors, it became its own storytelling piece. And when he was off stage, it was a weapon and it was comedy. And when it was on stage, it was a whole nother character.
So the famous courtroom scene in Chicago, we didn't have enough actors to play the entire jury. We only had one actor to play the entire jury. So Robbie Harper was given a box of props and costume pieces, and he was left to his own devices. And I tell you, to this day, I can't remember if Roxy was in that scene or not.
I think Robbie on stage in a perfect moment is every time Robbie's on stage, because he's super genuine and he's honest, and he also is so funny. Sometimes there may be some inside jokes that we do, and sometimes there may be some things that are kind of funny, and he's always playing along. He's a team player, playing along.
Silence! Silence. Bring back
Ooh, I think there's like a catalog.
He will cut a bitch, but his t-shirt will tell you he will never say that to you, and yet you know he means it.
A face from Robbie with shade might look something like this.
It's got the eye, it's kind of the
You must have a television.
No, he always says, I blink, but I think he's like quick there.
Someone else could say, and they would be funny, but when Robbie says it, they're just gems.
Seeing Robbie after the show, and he said, I don't remember directing that.
This is shade number 376. Huh. Okay.
Like, over the... Like, oh honey, it's like an over the top.
Oh gosh, those eye rolls.
This way or this way or forward.
I would be, Robbie, hey, did Michael reach out to you about this thing happening in Americano? And Robbie would be like, no.
That was delightful.
Robbie's impact on the Phoenix Theater Company and theater in the Valley, I think, is immeasurable.
He has had an enormous impact. I don't think I could cover it.
It is deep, it is profound, it is long-lasting, it is widespread.
The impact that Robbie has had on Phoenix Theater is monumental.
Huge.
Vast.
And monstrous.
Is quite large.
Robbie's like this thing that is so a part of the whole that I don't know how to take him out of the whole to describe the whole.
He has impacted so many of the programs at Phoenix Theater. I mean, I could name just a few. The New Works Festival really flourished under Robbie. The Summer of Dance program, the musical theater intensive that we did, even some of the programs that I did for summer camp at the time, all have Robbie's mark.
We are in Summer of Dance 13, and it has really bonded the community together in a way that everyone's like, adult classes, this is so amazing, it's so wonderful.
I can't think of a single person that hasn't been impacted by Robbie, quite frankly.
I feel that we would not be who we are at the Phoenix Theater Company if Robbie Harper had not been a part of us.
Just being around him at work has an impact on people.
He's brought new talent into Phoenix Theater as well as other companies because it's like, call Robbie, he'll know. He'll recommend somebody.
The impact that Robbie has specifically made on Phoenix Theater and our community, I can speak to, would be the Festival of New American Theater or the various names that it may have had over the years. Robbie has spearheaded this and has developed this in our community, which is something that I know gets talked about around the country when I travel to different playwriting events. Makes me proud. And I know that it's because of Robbie that it's happened and it has the reputation that it has.
What Robbie has done in terms of impact in the theater community at large in Phoenix is be by far the best director they've ever had.
His work is so stunningly beautiful.
The level of quality of his work and depth has raised the bar of professionalism.
I think he is truly the heart of that theater.
That is impossible to answer. There's only one true answer for that, and it's not vanilla.
Vanilla, but with like, kind of like how Ben and Jerry's vanilla is, where there's like chunks of things in it.
So one half of it would be like Rocky Road.
Rocky Road, I think, because it has crunchy nuts.
And then there's like a big chunk of like chocolate in it or a big chunk of something spicy. it's really pretty even tempered. And then, oh, wow, what's that? Oh, this is great. Oh, wow, what's that? Oh, this is really good.
And so there's a little bit of crunch, but there's sweetness and there's a little salty and sweet together. I think it's kind of perfect, Robbie.
Salted caramel.
Pralines and cream from Baskin Robbins.
Chocolate caramel peanut.
Maybe like a butter pecan.
It's that richness, yeah, but there's also a couple nuts in it because there's a little nuttiness too.
Chili peach flavored ice cream because he's a little spicy and he's from Georgia.
Robbie would be red wine flavored ice cream, and because he loves red wine and I love red wine, we enjoy that together.
Can I say tea for me? Just because it's so many colors, it's so many flavors, it's so many things. That's it. And it's sweet and delicious and goes to me.
If Robbie was a flavor of ice cream, I'm going with sorbet. And the reason for that is it's both tangy, extremely sweet, and packs a punch.
Raspberry zinger. I don't even know if that's ice cream flavor, but it is in my head. And because he's so sassy and brassy.
He would be rainbow sherbet because obviously unicorns love rainbows.
A rainbow unicorn swirl that is magical and colorful and bright and sparkly, and maybe there's some sprinkles on that side.
If Robbie was an ice cream, I think he would be all love and no oven from Cold Stone Creamery. I say that because it's colorful and it's sweet, and there's a lot packed into that ice cream.
If Robbie were an ice cream, I think he'd be a Neapolitan.
Neapolitan.
Neapolitan?
Spumoni came into my head.
Because he's got some sass in there. You know, that pink.
The different flavors all crunched up in one thing.
He's got that white, and then he's got that chocolate honey.
He's got so many colors to him.
He's multicolored. He's multifaceted. He isn't one flavor.
Mixed all together. You know what I'm saying?
And plus, Spumoni sounds pretty. Roberto Spumoni would be Robbie.
When are you gonna come down? When are you going to land? I should have stayed on the phone. Should have listened to my old man. No, you can't hold me forever. Didn't sign up with you. I'm not a present for your friends to open. This boy's too young to be singing the...
If Robbie is this plant, I would plant him dead center in the middle of the city in a park because everyone needs this plant.
To me, it's not one spot. I think that Robbie's a plant that can be transplanted, and he will thrive wherever he is transplanted.
Robbie were a plant being repotted. I would hope that he would find a very nice pot. I mean, a very nice pot.
I would put it in a location that gave it some sunshine or brightness, because that's what he brings to us. Some shade for the times that we all need to be alone and reflect, because he is so wonderful and good at that.
That pot would be filled with very rich soil. Deep, dark, rich soil. Like a compost heap.
He needs to be planted in a place that has wide open spaces and lots of opportunity for him to grow even larger than he's growing. I think if given the room, he's gonna take advantage of those opportunities and he's gonna grow larger than we've ever seen.
Maybe in Mexico. Some marijuana and Mexican boys.
I think I would put it somewhere not hot. Like not hot. Like not hot
that's the soil that Robbie deserves and belongs in, so that he has all of those nutrients to feed his unbridled creativity and his limitless possibilities.
My beautiful Robbie plant would be in kind of a cosmic, star-filled environment where it would be full of color, it would be full of music, where it could just breathe in all of the art and the goodness and the joy and the love, because what he would give out would be like 100 times more. It's just mind-boggling to me what he has inside him.
If Robbie was a plant, where would I plant him? In a place where people are so kind to him. Because he deserves that and so much more. Goodbye, a brick road where the dogs of society howl. You can't plant me in your penthouse.